Welcome, everybody, to another episode of Up, Up, Down, Down. This is Superstar Savepoint. And this week, me, El Murpho, I'm your host. I'm standing in for Austin Creed. And I have with me a very special guest. He is the voice of Extreme. He is also my neighbor, my desk neighbor here at the Stamford offices, Mr. Joey Styles.
Hello, El Murpho. And to you, Austin Creed, I'm kind of glad you're not here, because then we don't have to listen to your ridiculous New Day clap.
Ooh.
New
Shots fired.
Day rocks. New Day rocks. So the game's called Guacamelee.
Yes.
Which is, frankly, a little, you know, demeaning to the great legacy of Lucha Libre. So you cannot hold us responsible for the name, although it is catchy.
So what we are going to do is we're going to get in on some co-op action here, run around, see what we can do, and also hopefully learn a little bit more about Joey here.
Which way are we going?
We're
going
to go left to start off.
All right.
I believe so. I think we can go into places. Meet these guys up. Grab on them, grapple them.
Hold on. I want to throw a suplex. Yes. See ya.
So for those of you who don't know, Joey, what is it that that you do nowadays for WWE?
I am in digital media content. I do a lot of writing and editing. And this week I spent a lot of time interviewing WWE alumni. What I usually do is interview the alumni, legends, Hall of Famers. Doing an article looking for predictions on Brock Lesnar versus The Undertaker at SummerSlam. So I interviewed Edge and my friends of 20 plus years, Tommy Dreamer and Taz. Where is my character?
You're that circle. Remember, you got to hover over where I am.
Oh, I have
with
to hover
circle.
Over where you are.
Yeah, so, and then press the A button to resurrect.
So while our team on the road does interviews with our current talent, when it comes to interviewing legends, Hall of Famers, alumni, I usually do that because, you know, they're mostly my age and I have everyone on my phone and it's quick and easy. And once in a while, you'll see me host an ECW DVD. I'll call some stop-motion action figure matches for Mattel. You've got me playing Guacamelee.
You do a little bit of everything.
I do. I just got off a call where I was working with our sales team. It was a fun call. That's when you came and grabbed me.
Joey, we got to play video games.
Yeah, we got to play video games. get off the phone with that multi-billion-dollar client. Yeah.
So we know what you're doing now with WWE. Why don't you tell everybody how you got started in the business?
Well, when I was 13 years old, I saw my first match about a mile from here where I grew up, believe it or not, oddly enough, coincidentally. Grew up here in Stamford, Connecticut. It was the Wild Samoans with Captain Lou Albano losing the then WWF Tag Team Championships to Rocky Johnson, The Rock's dad, and Tony Atlas, the first black World Tag Team Champions, and I was hooked, and I decided that I wanted to be a superstar, and then I realized that God did not bless me with those attributes, but I had a quick wit and a big mouth, so I decided I wanted to be an announcer, and I chose Hofstra University on Long Island because they had a program where you could study TV, among other things, and more importantly, because Pro Wrestling Illustrated was published on Long Island at the time. And my plan was to get an internship there and make inroads into our business. And that's exactly what I did. I followed the game plan to a T, wound up being the announcer for ECW. Mm-hmm. And then ECW went out of business, came to work for WWE. And that was almost 10 years ago. So here I am now in digital media playing Guacamelee with you. I never would have guessed that I could make a living interviewing my friends for predictions on sports entertainment matches and playing video games. So it's a pretty sweet gig.
Mm-hmm.
I've done worse.
I would have been shocked if you had the foresight to be able to predict that.
ECW was the most fun I've ever had at any job, and I will say that working in WWE digital media is the best office job I've ever had, by far. I mean, look, we're playing a video game right now. It's pretty cool.
How long were you on there for?
6 months on Raw, ending with what we call a shoot promo, where I went out there and told the world, my boss, what I thought of him and sports entertainment. And then I was put on the new ECW, and then I was constantly complaining about the website back then, WWE.com. So finally, they needed to get Mike Adamly on the air somewhere, which is tremendous. That's another joke. And Vince said, I have a new assignment for you. I'm moving you into digital media. And at first, I was upset because I wouldn't be announcing anymore. Mm-hmm. And then I realized, and I was told, that I would have a very long and fruitful career. And sure enough, I've been in digital media for 7.5 years, which is longer than some announcing careers last year.
Yeah.
And I expect to be here for many more years.
Yeah. All right.
As you can tell, I'm not a gamer.
There we go.
the last time I actually played video games on a regular basis is when you had to go to a convenience store or an arcade.
Back in the Pac-Man days?
Yeah, I played Ms. Pac-Man, Donkey Kong, and Q-Bert. So I'm not a gamer. Little Joey Styles Jr. is a huge gamer, loves his Nintendo games. I mean, from NES to GameCube, 64 to Wii to the Wii U.
And he's going to a camp now to design video games,
isn't
he?
This summer he went to computer camp, and he's not even 12 years old yet. And at this camp they had him design his own mobile app. He designed a game. And then he made a video game for the PC, which is kind of cool. I'm going to put you on the spot. What's your prediction for Brock Lesnar versus Undertaker?
Brock Lesnar versus Undertaker? I think I'm going to go with Brock Lesnar.
Really?
Yeah.
I think I'm going to go with Undertaker. I think he's going to continue to fight dirty. I mean, he can't low blow Brock Lesnar in front of the referee. Obviously, he'll get disqualified. Yeah. But I think he'll find a way to turn the distraction of Paul Heyman against Brock, and he will, quite frankly, cheat to win.
I wouldn't be surprised if Brock, I heard somebody else saying it in the office, and I kind of agree with him. I wouldn't be surprised if Brock, you know, cheated himself to win, to get a little bit of payback on Taker. And there was also that awesome little security at ESPN thing that he did.
Oh, yes, today. As the security guard, Chris Carter loved it.
Yes.
You can go see that at WWE.com, cheap plug, and type in Brock Lesnar Security ESPN into the search bar.
Yes.
And you'll see the very funny video that we are speaking about.
No, you're not much of a gamer.
No.
You do, however, you are a fan of a certain particular superhero, comic books.
Oh, wow. That was a horrible segue, but yes, I'm a huge Batman fan. Let's put it this way. If you set up any of the Arkham games, I probably couldn't play them because they'd be too complicated, but I would definitely watch. That's what I do with my son. I watch him play Nintendo games. But yes, I am a huge Batman fan.
What of Batman do you watch or read? Do you read any of the comics? Have you seen any of the movies? Did you watch the old Adam West TV series?
I love the Adam West TV series. I watched it in reruns because I was born in 1971. Mm-hmm. In fact, rest in peace, Yvonne Craig, who played Batgirl. Yeah, I loved Adam West as Batman. I thought it was campy. It was fun. You know, obviously, I was very young at the time. And then I watched all the movies. I remember the first Michael Keaton movie. I remember waiting in line. That was the greatest thing ever. They were doing, here you go. They were doing a Batman movie. And then the movies got a little silly after that. And then I did enjoy the Dark Knight trilogy. And I'm looking forward to see Ben Affleck as Batman.
What's your take on Batfleck?
I know a lot of people, for some reason, are outraged. I think that Ben Affleck is a tremendous actor, but go watch Gone Girl. I mean, he's just a fantastic, dramatic actor. Are we still talking to this goat? I'm not getting...
Yes, apparently we've learned something called the rooster uppercut.
Okay, wow. I would assume a rooster uppercut would be very useful in cockfighting.
Mm-hmm. Jokes on jokes on jokes.
Yes, I'll be here all week. Try the veal.
So I don't mean to break your concentration, but while we're on the subject of Ben Affleck Batman, how do you feel about... Have you checked out the Superman, Batman vs. Superman and the Suicide Squad trailers?
Yes. Have you? Well, I saw the Batman vs. Superman animated film, so I'm hoping it doesn't give the whole story away. And Suicide Squad, I think, is a very unique concept. I kind of got a taste for some of those characters watching Arrow. Stephen Amell, who plays Arrow, will be teaming with Neville this Sunday at SummerSlam against Stardust and Cosmic King Barrett. See that? Everything for me goes back into selling. You have to sell, you know.
You're the promotion king.
That's
right
it.
Now.
That's what I do. That's what I do is I sell WWE, all things WWE. As far as Stephen Amell Sunday, if people think he's just another actor getting in the ring and he's going to be out of his depth, I suggest you go on YouTube and search Stephen Amell parkour and see the way he can move around, and I think he'll be very comfortable in the ring.
He's a very good parkour guy.
Oh my God, like John Morrison good.
So you are predicting a Neville and Stephen Amell upset?
I am predicting that Stephen Amell will get the pinfall on Stardust.
Ooh.
Yes.
And with that bold prediction, I believe we are actually out of time.
Really, that went fast. I can see where people can spend their whole evening and whole weekend gaming. So I'm glad you put a timer on this. But thanks a lot, El Murpho, for having me on
Up, Up, Down, Down.
Austin Creed, you'll be back next week, and you won't be nearly as interesting as I will. I know you're well-spoken. You're going to get your PhD soon and everything else, but I don't sit there clapping.
Here at Up, Up, Down, Down, we like to promote social media. So
sure. At Joey Styles, hit me up on Twitter, and I cherry pick some of the best stories from WWE.com, and I will answer any and all questions, which is great because they often get me in trouble. Never mind, I won't get into the stories. But yeah, I'll answer anything you ask me, quite frankly.
And you can find me at _Murpho_. And you can also follow us, the channel, Up, Up, Down, Down. Please do, on Instagram and on Twitter. We are Up, Up, Down, Down, without the O's. No O's there. You can also find us on Facebook. That place, we do have the O's. So search Up, Up, Down, Down, with the O's on Facebook, without the O's on Instagram and Twitter. And also, as always, be sure to like, subscribe, comment on our videos. Let us know what you like. Let us know what you don't like. Let us know what you don't, what you do, don't want to see. Let us know if you want us to have certain superstars or personalities on Superstar Save Point and Gamer Gauntlets. If you want Joey back and you think Joey was a lot of fun, if you thought it was a lot of fun watching him fumble around with the controls and telling stories about ECW, comment and let us know if you want him back, and we'll have him back. Joey would love to come back.
I'll tell you what, if I come back, yes, you have to sit by and watch my horrible gaming abilities, or lack thereof, but if you submit a bunch of questions and comments under the video, I will answer your questions while gaming. So that might make things interesting. That's how you get me back. I'll come back to answer questions while gaming.
Yeah, so you can get a Joey Styles Q&A edition of Superstar Save Point if you guys want to see him back. So flood the comments with any questions you have for Joey Styles. If there's enough demand, we'll try to get him back. Joey, once again.
Oh,
thank you,
El Murpho.
So much. And as always, when we close out our videos, we point to the camera.
Okay.
And we tell our viewers that no matter what the situation, regardless of what happens, you always keep it tight.
You think I can pull that off?
I think you can pull it off.
I'm like my mid-40s.
Yeah. Keep it tight.
Keep it tight. You're like Ted Baxter. And that's a throwback reference.
I don't know if anybody's
going to
get that.
No, nobody's going to get that. No, it's like Brockman from The Simpsons.
Yeah.
Keep it tight.